Next comes the property sheets. The property sheets is simple, as it will be used to present the complete properties of any applications or complete properties of any software. Okay. So here, if you see the example, in that example, what is the property sheets that we are seeing here? It's like you are changing the date and time of your system. So you go for properties. Here you give to change the date and time. So whenever you click on that date and time, you can just select the date and time, and you will click on either OK button or you will click on either cancel button. So you are changing the property of your system. So if there are any changes that you need to do to the system or to the any applications or to any software, usually you go for the properties of that particular application and you do the changes, and that changes which you did in properties will be applicable to that particular application. So that properties window we call, which it will display, we call here it as property sheets. Okay, so what is, what should be the size of that property sheets? It is written here. What is DLU? What is DLU? DLU is dialog box unit. It is dialog box unit, which will be basically used whenever you go for graphical user interface. So whenever the designer try to design the secondary window interface, they have to follow this, that we call it as dialog box unit, that is DLU. So the recommended sizes for the property sheets will be 252 DLU wide into 218 DLU high. So DLU is dialog box unit. That which means DLU give the it's the abbreviation of DLU is digital line unit, which will be used for dialog boxes. To design a dialog box, we go for DLU, that is digital line unit. Now here also there will be command buttons like OK and cancel. You can see in this diagram, and in this diagram once again you can see OK, cancel, and other than that you can see one more command button which is called apply. So apply means whatever the changes that you are doing in the properties, you want to apply that changes to the particular application, then you have to click on apply. Okay, so here the command buttons can also include OK, cancel, apply, reset, or others, whatever it is necessary to the changes of the property to apply, all that buttons you can include in the property sheet. Yeah, the last comes message boxes. Before that, we will see property inspectors. Property inspectors means there are some properties which will be frequently used. Say as here with the example, whenever you are doing a report, there is a necessity that all the font style of the content should be in Times New Roman, and you have to maintain the font size. So these two properties will be frequently used. So there are some properties which are frequently used. Those properties can be made to display without disappearing from the screen. So one example you can see here, this text properties. This properties can be made to display on the screen as it is used frequently. Okay. Then comes message boxes. Message boxes is one example diagram which I'm showing here. The selected disk drive is not in use. Check to make sure a disk is inserted. So here once again, have you heard something about alert messages? Alert messages is if there are any changes that is happening without your notification, there will be some alert messages which will be displaying. So those type of alert messages which it will display, we call that as message boxes. So the here one message is the selected disk drive is not in use. Check to make sure a disk is inserted. So without inserting a disk, when you try to open a disk drive, there is one alert message it will display. So that type of messages or some warnings which will display, those warning messages will also, we call it as message boxes. Okay. So here, even in the message boxes, there should be some action that need to take place, and there are some command buttons which will be used. So here, whenever it will show an alert message or whenever it shows some warnings, you have to perform some action. Either you need to click on retry or either you need to click on cancel. So if the user performs any action, then the secondary message box will disappear. So these are the command buttons. So the command buttons can be either retry or it can be either cancel. And the last one is palette windows. Palette window, it is used to present a set of controls. It is nothing but the toolboxes. Toolboxes which will be resizable and which will be displayed whenever the user needs to display it on the screen, whenever the user select that particular toolbox. So you can see one example here, which we will use it in Paint. Okay. In Paint, there will be tools. So that tool palette will be displayed whenever you click on that particular tool. So when you uncheck that, this will disappear. So this type of windows, we call it as palette windows. Yeah, and the last one, sorry, it is pop-up windows. Pop-up windows is, once again, when I right-click on whenever I right-click in at any of the places, it will display one window, and this type of windows, we call it as pop-up windows. And when you open n number of applications, and in the below lane, you can see that all that application should be closed. So you can right click on that. When you right click on that, it will show many options. So in that option, you will be having like close, move, size. So you can just click whichever the option you need. So this type of windows, we call it as pop-up windows.